Hello and welcome to Family Outings TV, today from Yorkshire Wildlife Park. Now, we've never been here before, but first impressions look absolutely amazing. Thank you very much to Yorkshire Wildlife Park for giving us free entry today whilst we do what we call a familiarisation visit. So we come here, check it out, so that we've got all of the information for any of our passengers that are coming here from Teesside on one of our coach trips. But I'm going to give you a spin round, have a look. Now, the first thing that when you enter Yorkshire Wildlife Park is that there is a kind of complex of shops and other things here. So you've got over there, you've got like a soft play, you've got an experience restaurant, Evolution, and it just looks lovely. Just this area here is just getting finished off, so that'll be all landscaped by the time our first trips come here. But you've got like lovely little quaint shops, not big brands. It seems to be like quite small independent shops, which is lovely to see, being able to afford these premises. And over in the distance there, Evolution Experience Restaurant, I've been told that is actually a dinosaur themed restaurant. Now me, I've been to T-Rex restaurant over in Florida, and I'm hoping it's something a little bit like that. I very much doubt it, but if it's anywhere near it, it will be amazing as well. So I'm gonna go try and get into there for lunch or tea time this evening, and kind of see what sort of food they have on offer in there, and also the theming around it. But just look, you've got lots of, this is before you even enter the park. You've got like this stage area here where during peak times they'll have shows on. You've got, as I say, that experience restaurant I've just mentioned, and then the uproar play barn. Now I've been in there, it looks amazing, but obviously for obvious reasons, because the children in there, I can't film in there. But that's a soft play area, and it's lovely and modern, nice and big. And then we've got coffee shops here out on the outskirts of the park as well. So it's all just been done. It really is a great first impression. It's very modern, very clean, and I'm excited to get inside and have a look at the animals, because let's be honest, that's the reason we're coming here, for the animals. So let's go inside and take a look at Yorkshire Wildlife Park. So this area looks totally new. I believe the entrance area of this zoo has totally been changed, but it's just clean. Look at the lovely store here. Nice open area for plenty of people, so during peak times you're not shoulder to shoulder. And then just, yeah, nicely organized turnstiles. So yeah, great first impression. Let's get inside and take a look. Right, so we've just come through the main entrance here. And one thing I would say straight away is that it's very different to other zoos that we've been to. It seems very, not many buildings here, so it seems very open, which isn't a bad thing. We're going to have a look around and see, obviously, everything that is here. But you don't see many buildings there, but it could be an illusion. We could get beyond these paths and we could see lots of buildings and, you know, homes for the animals. But initially, seems very very different kind of zoo experience. But again, these paths are lovely and wide, very good for wheelchairs and pushchairs. So first thing I'm going to do is take a right here and have a look at Point Lobos, which presumably looks like sea lions. Right, so here we are at the sea lion area. Lovely little habitat. I've just seen them pop out, so we will I'll wait here and hopefully get some video of them. But they'll just pop out the water a second ago. There we have one on the rock there, just in the middle, just chilling, popping his head up and down. And then over there, you've got a few swimming with the head above the water. But yeah, looks a lovely little area for them here. Plenty of place to swim. And it looks lovely and clean as well. And then here, it looks like some sort of chute that maybe you can pay to feed them at some point, but that just goes down into the water. I'm not sure if that's just for the zookeepers, but nonetheless, it is a shoot for food. Here we can see them swimming. He just had his head out the water. He's showing off, doing handstands with his fins out the water. So those are the Californian sea lions. Right, so let's continue on our journey and see what we can find. But yeah, loving it here so far. It's great. How cute are these little things? And I don't know if you can hear it, but it keeps going just like that. Look at them. Super cute. But again, look at this area here. It's lovely for them all. Plenty of space. Some more coming here. There's some more. There they are again. So if you haven't seen these before, these are actually bush dogs. Here's another one. But yeah, let's move on, see what else we can see. So here we are, the lowland tapir. And we'll have a little look over here now. See him in the shelter, or her in the shelter there, just moving left. And then there's another one just over there to the right. Once again, plenty of space here. Lovely little habitat for them. Everything looks brand new. I'm not sure if that's the case, but I know this zoo has been here for quite a while. Here we are, getting a bit closer. And there they are together. Alright, so just round the corner from the tapirs is this lovely picnic area. So if you aren't planning on using the in-house dining as such, or catering, then you can always bring a picnic, and there's some lovely picnic tables here. I mentioned last week at Twycross Zoo, it's always good having plenty of seating and picnic areas, and I would imagine in the spring, or later in the spring and summer, there'll probably be a lot more picnic tables in this area as well, so that's ideal. And just here, I've just come around the corner again, this is another actual area for the sea lions. So they've got this upper area here, and then if in the distance just over there, that's the original one that I filmed just a few moments ago. So they've actually got two areas. They've got that big area over there, and then they've got this smaller but still a decent size area here. So sea lions have got a good life. So I mentioned at the beginning there wasn't many buildings that I could see so far. Again, I've not seen any kind of shops or cafes or anything. And then we do have this mobile, what I can assume is a catering van, which I would assume again would be open during peak times. So interesting to know what sort of things that they sell. I can't see any gas or electric hookups underneath, so I would imagine it would just be kind of snacks and maybe refrigerated drinks. But yeah, that's a bit strange. So far, I mean, I'm not saying it's a bad thing, but in the summer, I suppose if you were thirsty or hungry, there's probably an opportunity that's being missed right now. But maybe that maybe there's more kind of portable areas that they bring out during peak times, so that there's plenty of places for people to get food and drink, particularly if it's a really hot day and people are dehydrated. But here we are. Let's have a look at this map. Alright, so there you have it, the map of Yorkshire Wildlife Park. And where are we? We've just passed the Atlantic Forest there on the right hand side. So there's a long way to go, it goes quite far back. And as you can see over on the far end, there does appear to be a lot more buildings. So perhaps this right hand side is the new area and the left hand side is the old area with all of the kiosks and things. So let's investigate and find out more. I'm intrigued. Here we have the red panda enclosure. Can't see any out and about at the moment, maybe too cold for them. But again, look at this lovely little area for them. Loads of places to play on those long logs. Just their hut, keep them warm probably. Do see a few people over here, so let's have a look. Probably over here. Oh, there's one. Amazing was that red panda, and then got this random set of mirrors here for the kids to play in. Optical illusions, let's go in here, this will be confusing. Oh, here we are. But again, just something for the kids to enjoy for a minute or two. And here we have the smooth coated otter enclosure. I can't see any here, but yeah, you can see the area that they get to roam about in, obviously the water down there, but they're not out at the moment, which is always a risk you take when you come to the zoo. And then here, just next to the red panda enclosure and the otter enclosure, you've got a little mini play area for the kids. Little bridge, watchtower, little telescope there at the top. Nice little touches around this park, just to keep the kids engaged in between looking at the animals. Right, onward to experience Ethiopia. But again, I know I keep saying it, this is the last time I'm going to say it. I just love the, it seems such a simple thing, but even the pathways just being so good and wide, it's nice, because sometimes they're a little bit narrow and it's congested, but I would imagine even in the summer there's plenty of space here to get around. So it's really well thought through. And look, we can see some, oh, here we go. What are they? I'm not even going to guess. They're an ape of some type. Let's have a look. A gelada. So here we are. On the top of the hill there. I'm going to go try and see if we can see some around the other side. I think they're all over there. There you can see an adult gelada and what I'm assuming is a baby. Or child. Looks a bit older than a baby, but still young. Yeah, just chilling, having some food. And as we walk around the corner, yet another play area. I'm glad that I'm here now, actually, when it's quiet, because obviously normally I can't film these play areas when there's kids on them for obvious reasons. But as it is a term time weekday, I'm able to do that for you. But yeah, just look. I mean, again, another 10-15 minutes for your kids to just have a little play on this play area. Play area rules and hand sanitizer. And then refreshments here. Again, I wouldn't expect these to be open during term time. But you can see actually what the sort of things they offer. Ice creams, I would imagine cold drinks, possibly hot drinks, who knows. But yeah, there you are. And we continue. Here's the other side of the hill there, of the Galada. Monkeys, you can see a few there and a few over here as well. Once again, just look at the amount of space that they have. You certainly can't knock that. They've got those little caves there where they can go in when it's cold, keep themselves warm. I would imagine probably all kind of huddle in together, keep themselves warm. But there is a what looks like a hut there next to this as well, where I would imagine they can go in, and it's probably a little bit more warmer and covered in from the elements. It just here on the right hand side there should be some hyenas, but I'm presuming they're not out today. Perhaps they'll be out later. The hyenas of Hurrah. You can hear them making a noise there, so perhaps they're just round the back. And there seems to be some people here looking, so maybe we'll get a spot. I'm not sure if you'll be able to see them here. Between on the right hand side of the big access gate there, on the right post, just between the two posts there to the right, there is a couple of hyenas. And here we are on the bridge. Now on the map, this bridge kind of crossed over to another main section. So I'm presuming the area we've just come from, again, this is a total assumption, it is a brand new area because everything looks quite new, to be honest. And I would imagine this was the older half, or not the older half, the original half. So I would imagine to see maybe things looking a little bit older. But that's my assumption, totally not based upon facts at all. I'll have to do some research when I leave here. But yeah, I do know the car park was originally on this side that we're walking to now, and they've only just moved the car park to where we just came from. So it does suggest that that side is the new side. It's obviously got the new restaurant and everything on the outside. So it does seem that way. And yeah, let's go see what's over here. But I know there was a lot of things over here, kiosks, food, coffee shops. So we'll go take a look what's over here. I know the lions are over here, polar bears. But it's a nice little walk over this bridge. Nothing really to see. I'm not sure if there should be anything to see, but some nice terrain here. Just have a look out there. And then on the other side, the same. So yeah, let's keep walking. We'll see what we can see. Right, so we've got over to the other side, and yeah, as I thought, you can see the wood is aged a lot more over here. Not in a bad way, it's not falling apart or anything, just the fact that you can see on the other side the wood is a lot brighter, a lot fresher, not being through a few years weathering. So still backing up. And then here you've got the leopard snack den menu. Teas, coffees, hot cold drinks, ice creams, donuts. So be able to get things. Oh, look at this. And a waffle, I love a good waffle. So a waffle as well there. So yep, another little snack area once we've got to the other side of that bridge. And look at some of these as well, these souvenir cups. Pretty cool. Leo the lion, Ronnie the rhino. They're pretty good, aren't they, with a bit of ice cream in. Kids would love that. Ooh, what's your favourite ice cream on here? Mine would probably be the Oreo ice cream sandwich. Comment below with your choice. Let's have a look. And then you've got your vending machines and things here. I'm gonna have a look at this leopard enclosure, and then I think I want to grab myself a coffee. I can see a coffee house over there, and I am parched. Probably grab myself a tea actually. I've had a couple of cups of coffee already today, so have a cup of tea. But yeah, here's the leopard enclosure, so we'll take a look at this. So here we are, all leopard enclosure. Can't see any leopards though, but just look at the structure there at the back for them all to climb on. Pretty impressive. But if you go around the other side over here, and I know they're out because I've seen them, the giraffes are out. How awesome. Thank you. typically they've probably said, I'm having enough now, I'm going inside, just as I come over to film them. But you get a good view. Great little view up here. But look at that coffee shop over there. Oof. Maasai coffee shop. Oh, the giraffes aren't going in. He's tricking me. Oh no, he's tricking me again. He is going in, or she is going in. I wonder if you can get inside there and have a look. We'll certainly try. But in the meantime, I'm gonna go grab myself a cup of tea. On the way to the coffee shop, look what we spotted. Nice little tiger here. Wow. Impressive, aren't the tigers? Well, there they are, they're off. Glad we caught that. Right, so here we are, Maasai coffee shop. Sausage rolls, pasty, soup, pizza slices. There's a picture of the pizza. Soup of the day, today, tomato and basil. Lovely little coffee shop. Usuals in the fridges. Great kid sandwiches. £2.50. Kids drinks. And then adult sandwiches, £3.25, which is about going rate in a theme park, a zoo, wraps. Got everything here. So a lovely little coffee shop. I was there gonna grab myself cup of tea and possibly a snack. They also very randomly sell a cheeky little tipple, so you can have a little cheeky little drink, just the one of course. Not wrong with that. But yeah, not many places do that, so I am surprised. I think it's just about being responsible, isn't it? But yeah, don't see that very often. Right, so fed and watered, now let's go see the giraffe's house. Right, so there you had the indoor giraffe area. It seemed like that particular giraffe was being trained to put its foot on the bench there, probably to for some sort of treatments when they need them on the feet. But yeah, you can see the indoor area, nice and spacious. But then obviously earlier in the vlog you will have seen the outdoor area where there was plenty of space for them. So we keep walking, and I can see ahead of me here now a massive play area. I will do a glancing film across the area, but obviously I won't spend too long filming. Just a quick panoramic of the area for obvious reasons. If there is, mind you, some of the areas don't have any kids on, so I will try and film them for you because it's great to see. I mean, my kids could probably spend half an hour here to an hour. So yeah, let's have a little look. Just see over there, there's like a rope course over there, like log course, another rope course, slide, and then over here a smaller area for the toddlers and things, and then there's like seesaws here at the front. I don't know if you can see that, the seesaws just there, and then like another like tire, well, it's not actual tire but in the shape of a tire, big tire swing with the net in, and then over at the back there's a zip line. So this is great, isn't it? So actually, yeah, this is a great little play area for the kids. Again, just breaks up the day, doesn't it? Keeps the kids' attention, and lets the parents have a little sit down as well. Let's not underestimate that. So I'm going to walk over here now. I'm not sure where I'm going, but we will see and see what we can find over here. Right, so Project Polar 2. If anyone can fill me in why it's 2, what happened to number 1? That'd be good. But I presume we're gonna see some polar bears. Oh yep, there's one. Just in the distance there. Awesome. Not too sure how many places in the UK have polar bears, but I can see 3 there. One walking towards us and then 2 up on the hills. I'll go down a bit for the camera to get some contrast. But yeah, look, again, plenty of space, and then a nice little indoor area for them here. There's polar bears, like, up. had enough going for a sleep in my little house. I would imagine he or she is going to be going in that little entrance there, so we'll get a great view. Perfect timing. Oh, no. Typical. They were on the way to get closer and now changed the mind. But yep, polar bears, awesome. But just look at all that area they've got over there. Brilliant. I don't know if there's any closer walkways near to the polar bears on the hill, but we will go find out. Can't actually get any closer to the polar bears, however, can get a bit higher to get a bit of a better a view. That sun's just lashing down on us now, but you can see the polar bears there up on the top of the hill, just behind the water there. And then over here, which is very random. Now, you probably think, oh, that looks like a sewage works and it probably stinks, but there's no smell. And to be honest, I'm not entirely sure what it is, because I would have thought if it was sewage, a sewage treatment plant of some sort, it would smell, but there's no smell around here. Just for your important reference, perhaps in the summer that might be different, but that is very random to have this just smack bang in the middle of a zoo. Yeah, also pretty good for the kids to explain this is what happens. Right, gonna head back towards the coffee shop way now, but here's just another quick view of that play area. And here we just, there's just a little peak here, just around the corner from where we've just been to the polar bears. There's nothing out at the moment, but this area here is meant to be for Bactrian camels. I say a little area, again, massive area. I mean, we go to a lot of zoos, and you know, Chester Zoo is probably my favourite in the UK, although this one at the moment is coming very close. I haven't discovered it all yet, so watch this space. But there is a lot of space at this zoo, equally if not more than Chester Zoo for the animals. Chester Zoo does look like it's an overall bigger zoo in regards to kind of the overall space, but the space for the animals here does seem to be the most I've seen out of all the zoos. So that's great, isn't it? You know, not saying Chester Zoo doesn't have lots of space for the animals, it does, but this is a lot of space. This is a lot of space for the animals. Chester Zoo is a great zoo, and it certainly looks after their animals, and they do get plenty of space, but this almost seems excessive, which is, you know, is that even possible? I don't think so. So yep, plenty of space here. We move on. I'm going to head back towards, this is kind of a cul-de-sac, so I'm going to head back now towards the coffee shop and the tiger area, and then there's the next area of the zoo to go look at. So I'll be back with you in just a moment. Nice and close to the giraffes here. Let's go into Africa, or is it? Let's go into Africa. Presuming it's let's go into Africa, because there'd be a space between in and to. What do you reckon? What do you reckon? Well, here we are, life on the savannah. Zebras, giraffes, we've seen them. No, sorry, we've seen the giraffes. Zebras are directly behind me, so I'll show you them in a second. Got the lechwe, the rhino, lionesses. We've seen the hyenas. We haven't seen any dung beetles, and we probably won't. But there's some zebras there in the distance. And again, just look at this. Look at it. All the space. And then on the left hand side here, I'm not sure what's meant to be here. Maybe I'll see a little information board in a second, but yeah, there's your zebras. And then in the background there, right at the back there, I'm not too sure what that is. But yeah, we'll keep going. If I spot anything, oh, can you see that bird on the fence there? Let's see how close I can get. Not very close at all. But there he is, look. It's like a tiny magpie. It's not a magpie, I know it wasn't a magpie, but it was black and white and it was like a robin. So tell me what that bird was. Robin body, black and white like a magpie. Maybe it was a black and white robin, who knows? Do they exist? Or maybe it was a robin that supported Newcastle. Right, black rhino. Eastern black rhino. Let's have a look over here, and what have we got? Right, so those things over there are the Kafui lechwe. Just over there, centre of the screen. They look a little bit deer-like. They're not a deer again. Always got to be careful, but look, here we are. The facts about the Kafui lechwe. This is a sub-aquatic antelope. It will graze in water and is an excellent swimmer. Huh? There you go. There you go. Right, let's go right. Project Polar, Land of the Tiger, South American Beaver. Yes, and on my way, here's some wallabies. Wallaby walkthrough. Got this little guy down here. Look at him. Or her. And you can just walk through this area. See the people there. Similar, they have the same sort of thing at Flamingo Land. It's pretty awesome. Seems to be a few more wallabies here, like. Probably maybe double the amount, to be honest. Seems a lot. But yeah, pretty awesome. Go through there with the kids. Kids can see them very close up. And they're just chilling. Another little picnic area here, of which there's quite a few dotted about, but this one's obviously undercover, which is pretty cool if it's raining or a little bit colder. But I do like a good picnic area in these attractions. Not even to eat picnics, just somehow to have a nice sit down. Right, let's have a look. Where are we? Ay caramba. So we've got the South American Viva. What's this here? Ay caramba. A taste of South America. Oh dear, I hope they don't cook the animals here. Right, so this is food. Right, I need to know where I am because I'm a bit lost. Right, so we are there. Project Polar. Right. I don't know where Project Polar 2 was. I am lost. But I do know what we've seen and what we haven't. So, yeah, let's keep going and see what more we can see. But yeah, this looks nice. A taste of South America. That would be interesting to see what's on that sort of menu. In fact, you know what? There's no stuff about. I'm going to be naughty and just go and have a look at the menu. And I can tell you, can I? And if I get told off, I'm going to blame you lot for watching this. Right, so we've got burrito meals, nachos, fries, dirty fries, a power box with refried beans and quinoa, jalapenos, spinach, that sounds quite nice. Churros, oh yes, love some churros. Pretty awesome, to be honest. Sounds lovely. So if you come peak season, I would imagine you can enjoy those dishes. Burrito meals about £8.75, nachos £4.50, and the fries between £2.80 and £3.90. And the dirty fries £6.25. So not cheap, not expensive though for theme park / attractions. That's the going rate. You just pay those prices. I talk about it all the time. It's more than just the cost of food when it comes to food in theme parks. You've got to think of the staff, you've got to think of the insurance, you've got to think that it's not just paying towards the food, it's paying towards feeding the animals and everything like that. So it's not just that, and it's the same for any attraction. You're not just paying for the food, it's how they make a little bit extra money to pay for other things. Admittedly, they make profit, but it's a business. Right, Jungle Lookout Adventure Place, or another play area over here. Let's have a little look down here since we're here. There's no kids in here again, so it's great that I can film this. Looks pretty awesome, to be honest. I mean, it looks very spooky. I mean, if this was like in a horror movie, I could imagine some eerie music, a little bit darker, bit of lighting, smoke. You've got a horror movie playground. But jokes aside, it does look awesome. Look, you've got all these play areas here. You've got a massive slide there. And a couple, like a two-level wooden play area there. Big picnic table here. And you've got in the background there just like a play area for the little kids. And yeah, it's great, isn't it? Kids would love this. Just not a dark, not smoke, and not scary characters chasing you around. It'd be lovely. Look at that, awesome. Right, a sign of a good zoo is that I'm getting lost. It means there's plenty to see, and I'm officially lost. Where, oh, Project Polar, right. So earlier I asked where Project Polar was, but it turns out Project Polar is still exists, and there's two polar areas by the sounds of it in the zoo. So here we go, polar bear alert. So that's strange, isn't it? I wonder why they've got two polar areas. I suppose we might find out, but here we are walking towards Project Polar, not Project Polar 2. So if you know why there's two polar bear areas in this zoo, then please comment below. But it's a nice little entrance, isn't it? Project Polar. I feel like we need like a soundtrack when you enter through here, a bit like Jurassic Park. No, I'm not feeling it. Right, here we are, Project Polar. Wow, so look at that polar bear over on the rocks there in the distance. Looks massive. And again, look at this area here. But yep, just on the distance down the rocks. And then if we go over here, there's also another one just there rolling around on the grass. Here we are, a little bit closer to one of the polar bears. Wowza, look at that. How amazing. Not many places you can get this close to a polar bear. Right, so this is the South America Viva, which is a walkthrough. I'm not sure what animals are in here, but let's have a walk through. Entrance. Doesn't say what's in here, but we'll take a look. I can only open this one, the other ones. Right, wow. Wowza. Hello, mate. We went to Twycross Zoo a couple of weeks ago, and these look very similar to the Dick Dicks, because we thought the name was quite funny. Little bit less deerish, but very similar at the same time. How cool is this? You can get nice and close, similar to the wallaby walkthrough that we that I filmed through the fence. But yeah, just nice landscaping as well, isn't it? And we've got some what we've got over here. It's funny how they're just staying in their own little area, because the information seems to be right for the animals. The capybara, the largest living rodent in the world. Look at them in there, over there. Hey, that's a rodent. The name capybara originally comes from the Guarani word capia, meaning roughly master of the grasses. So there you go, capybara, master of the grasses, just chilling. Let's look at what we can see next. There's no fences, yet they all stay in their own little areas, like, to know. How is that? This is the Mara. The Mara are also known as Patagonian hares. They're the world's fourth largest rodent. Look at this spot here. Hiya, mate. They're not scared of us humans at all, obviously used to us all walking through now. But yeah, they just stay in the little areas, right next to the little signposts, like they're being paid to do so. Not sure what this one is. The white-faced Saki. Saki's a Japanese drink. Saki. Can't see any, but this seems to be their little area with, like, lots of ropes and things. Let's see if you can spot one. Not seeing any. Need to sleep in, or they're too cold. None of you. Oh, but look, got another dude here. Hiya. It was good, enjoyed that. So yeah, if you come in here, you can have a little walk through, which is great. Right, so headed back to the wallaby walk through, but just look at all these here. Look at them all, everywhere. This dude here. Literally how close it can get. Hiya, mate. Hiya. And then we've got some more here. I say some loads. We'll just go over here, take a look at them eating. Look, there's a white one there. How weird is that? Look at that. Look at them eating. You can just see a baby in the pouch. Super cute. Right, so that was the wallaby walkthrough, and then we've got lemur woods. Never ending, this place, so much to do. I'd definitely say 100% you can spend a full day here, not only with the things inside the actual zoo, but obviously with the things they've added outside. So obviously the the soft play, the themed restaurant, the shops, the brewery, which I didn't point out as well as a mini brewery, but look at these. You can't see them in there. The lemurs. I like to move it, move it. See if there's any out here, because thing with glasses, you can't see through it with the reflection. Let's see if there's any out here. Well, look at this area for them all. It's amazing. I don't think I can see any, to be fair. There's none out here. Right, so that was lemur woods, but they weren't out. They weren't out. Well, there was some very, very high up in a tree. I spoke to one of the zookeepers there, but I couldn't catch them on the camera. I couldn't see them, to be honest. I'm blind. I've got my glasses on recently. So, but if you come here, obviously there was about 10 lemurs in that glass room before we actually went on the walkthrough. So it's just potluck, isn't it, really? Right, going to continue walking through. I think we've still got the lions and lionesses to see, and there's a little few bits and bobs I've missed along the way because I've got about an hour left, so there's a little bit of time, but I want to try and get some more footage of the restaurant as we leave, and also have a look at some of the shops as we leave and see kind of what sort of shops they have here. I was very conscious when we came in that I wanted to get as much of this done first, so we'll have a look at that. But we're going to go look at the lions, lionesses, and then on the way out we'll see if we pick up on anything on the way out. But I have definitely missed things. I didn't think it was this big, to be honest, which is great. So if you're watching this and you're coming on some of our trips, it's definitely a day attraction. There's plenty to do here, and check out our website, myfamilyoutings.co.uk, coach trips to Yorkshire Wildlife Zoo, departing from Teesside, Stockton, Middlesbrough, Hartlepool and Billingham. I keep saying Yorkshire Wildlife Zoo, Yorkshire Wildlife Park, same thing, just keep getting the names wrong. So yep, have a look at that, myfamilyoutings.co.uk, and also look on our Facebook page, Family Outings North East. Thank you. Yes, painted dogs, these are my favourites at Chester Zoo, so let's go see if we can find some painted dogs. There they are in the little cave there. Unfortunately, not close enough to really get a good eye to detail, but I love painted dogs. Don't know why, just love how they look. I love the way how they look, just little prance around. But yeah, there they are. Shame they're not a bit closer, but you can still see them in the cave on the left hand side. And just next to the painted dogs we've got the baboons. There's just one there in the centre of the picture that you might be able to see. I'm guessing there's a lot more inside. Oh, there's two. I can see two. Three. There's a few out here. But again, just look at the area they have. Not got it bad here, the animals. Right, so Funtastic Monkey Playhouse and Cafe. I wonder, let's have a look in here. Outlook Conference Suite. And the Playhouse. I'm gonna go take a look inside, obviously I'm not gonna film. But I wonder if this is a free play area. Yeah, so I've just been in there, spoke to a member of staff, and it's awesome actually, nice little play area. It's a soft play, slide your overhead things, and yeah, it's free, so there's no additional charge for that one like the one outside. So yeah, great, another little pit stop for your kids, particularly if it's raining or cold. You can just go in there, there's a cafe in there, coffee, teas, snacks. And then just out here there's also another little stack area, not open at the moment, but of course peak times it would be, and the same kind of menu that's been available on a lot of the snack places that we've seen around the zoo. So yeah, let's keep going, see what we can find. And here we have yet another picnic area. So yeah, picnic, sit down, perfect. And here we have another kind of courtyard area that serves food and things, classrooms, and then you've got a shop there as well. To be honest, I know the entrance had changed, so I suspect this was probably the entrance area only last year, and then changed it across to the other side, which was where I did my introduction from. So I think this is the area where it used to be, but we'll go inside, take a look at that gift shop very briefly. And then I saw a signpost over here to the Lions. So it got the gift shop here, lovely, spacious. It's got a little coffee shop there on the side as well, with some tables and chairs. I think they must have like drinks there that you can get. But yeah, just take a look. I mean, this is massive, this, to be fair. And you've got your typical gift shop stuff. Soft toys. Have a look at the little wallaby, kangaroo, $16.99. And some of the other stuff as well. Oh, look, cool little £30. Oh no, sorry, £80. Got that one wrong. But yeah, lovely little shop, lovely little gift shop. And there is another one on the other entrance, the original entrance. I'm unsure exactly what's happening with this place. I would imagine, you know, are they going to keep two massive gift shops? I'm not too sure, but we'll have a look at the other one on the way out. But it will sell the same things. Got books, soft toys, lots of other things, umbrellas, cars, everything you'd expect in a gift shop. And then obviously the cafe area here. Or is it an indoor picnic area? I'm not quite sure. Perhaps this is used for like schools or something. 10% off for annual pass holders. So yeah, nice little gift shop. So here we are, Lion Country. Let's see if any of them are out or we can spot any. Right, so you can see a lioness there, just on the brow of that hill there. And see a lion just to the right of her, just once we get past this gated area. Just there as well, obviously quite far away, so can't see them in too much detail, but nonetheless you can see them. And again, they've got plenty of space in here. And I believe, oh, how did I miss this guy? And then we've got this guy, so you can certainly see Mufasa here. And lioness just there up at the top. But yeah, how awesome is that? Nice and close. Proper see him in detail there. Just chilling. Keep saying that as well. Need to stop saying that, don't I? Chilling, chilling. He's relaxing, this guy. He's relaxing. But yeah, great. Great closeness to the animals. He's tired. So I'm heading back towards the entrance. I've just crossed the bridge from the old half to the new half. It's a big zoo, this. Very big. I'd probably say if you're at the back of the zoo, even if you're relatively fit or mobile like myself, you're probably looking about 10-15 minutes to walk from the back to the front, so obviously bear that in mind. All the paths are great, so perfect for pushchairs and wheelchairs, so no problem getting around. But yeah, it is a big zoo. I don't know whether I would recommend possibly coming in the zoo in the morning, nice slow walk to the back of the zoo, and then move your way forward, so that at the end of the day, when your legs are a little bit tired, you actually need the exit. I'd probably recommend that. But yeah, just bear that in mind when you're coming in here. It's a big zoo. I am tired. That is a long walk. But on the plus side, we're back near the bush dogs. I like the bush dogs too. There they are, look at them. Walking around the top there. There's another one. I love it. Bringing a lot of joy to people, obviously. So yeah, we're back near the entrance. I'm gonna take a look around the shops. And hopefully I'll be able to get in that themed restaurant and see what the decor looks like inside. Dinosaur themed, so yeah, hopefully I'll be able to get in there. So as we exit, there's another safari store there. We'll go have a quick glance in. I would imagine it's pretty much identical in regards to what it sells to the one that we saw at the back end of the park. We'll take a look just in case, you never know. There's a nice little figure out here, Playmobil Explorer type figure. I say Explorer, looks more like he's a zookeeper, isn't he? But yeah, let's go have a look. It's much the same in here, a lot of the soft toys and things. Some awesome little ornaments. They are priced £32.99. Little sweet cart. Cool little zoo Playmobil set as well. Display. I'd say this one's a little bit bigger than the other one. But yeah, a lot of soft toys. A lot of soft toys. Yeah, so it was pretty much the same as the other gift shop. However, there was a lot more adult orientated gifts in there. So pictures, ornaments, other bits and bobs in there. So there was more in there for adults. The other gift shop at the back was, I would say, primarily for kids. But here as well, you now have on site a hotel. So Yorkshire Wildlife Park has the Hex Hotel, and I don't know if you saw it in any of the video, but some of the rooms actually back onto the zoo. And you've also got Wild Bistro here. So there's quite a lot around here. Over there there's a brewery, I believe. I will have a little walk around this side. So we've got like little different quirky shops here. Wild Beauty coming soon. So this looks like it's just literally getting finished off. Speaking to a staff member at the beginning of the day, definitely by the summer, hopefully by kind of April time, late April, most of this will be complete. Not this actual frame here. I think it'll take a little bit longer for that to be completed, but most of the shops, the hotel, and kind of landscaping around this area that's just been finished off will be finished. There's going to be a water feature here, as you can probably figure out from how it looks. Here, you've got a shop here, the Wool Den. So everything you need from wool. And you've got this, which is like Badger Brewery. I'm making that name up, but there's a badger on it. Badger Brewery sounds good. And then in here you can see all where it's all brewed. You won't be able to see through the glass, but there is brewing equipment in there. And then around here, Katie Clark Boutique. So there's lots of shops around here, which is pretty interesting for an attraction. They've tried to combine shopping and leisure with a zoo, which I think will work, because when people come out, they're just looking to spend a bit of money. But also, forgetting the zoo, people might just come here anyway to get a few bits and bobs, a few artifacts. So you've got a double whammy. I think it'll be good. You've got Peppers of Yorkshire there. Seems to be like a gift shop, very Yorkshire orientated. Yorkshire tea, aprons, I'll do, very Yorkshire scene. And then here we are, the Evolution Experience restaurant. Let's go see if it's open. It doesn't look open. The lady said it would be open. Don't spoil my day, because I'm hoping it is. Wow, it's open. And it is very T-Rex theme, like down at Disney. This is amazing. Wow. This is the best themed restaurant I've seen in the UK. It's just amazing. Look at this theming. I understand at certain points there's like some sort of interaction, so I know they've said a dinosaur at certain points goes around the restaurant. Not too sure how that unfolds, but So there's like a spectacle every X amount of minutes. But it's very rainforest cafe type, like T-Rex restaurant in Florida. This is amazing. I suppose I'm gonna have to check out the food, aren't I? What do you think? I'm gonna have a look at the menu. If I can get something under 20 quid with a drink, I'm in, they've sold it to me. Because who wouldn't want to eat in here? This is awesome. So I'm in. Had to, didn't I really? Here's your menu here for you. Appetizers, mozzarella garlic flatbread, sharing platters, burgers, salads, pizza, obviously desserts. And then there's the drinks menu, you won't be able to see this much. Just look at the view. Love it. And to be honest, the food's not too bad. You're looking at a burger, £12.50, so you can't really go wrong. So I'm not sure if you can hear that, but this sounds like a dinosaur's approaching.
Oh,
there is a dinosaur approaching. Randomly, you keep getting these birds flying over here, and one of the animatronic burgers. God, just ordered a burger. One of the animatronic dinosaurs, not a burger. But yeah, I've ordered a burger with Stilton and mushroom, and I know you're all gonna go, but there's some people that still do like Stilton. Unfortunately, I'm one of them, but I'm looking forward to it. Who doesn't like Stilton? Who doesn't like mushrooms? So we'll have a look and see what the food's like in here. But yeah, you can't really go wrong for £12.50 for a burger in a theme restaurant like this. I personally think that's really good value. I guess we'll have to see what the food's like, eh? Some sort of thunderstorm happening. Lightning. Yes, look at that, looks lovely. Chips, coleslaw, burger, Stilton, and a mushroom on top. Right, so let's have a try. These chips, paprika chips. Paprika-y, very nice. Bit of salt needed. Much better with salt. Obviously they've not added that, which is fine. The burger. This bad boy burger, yes. Take me flag out. I don't know if I'm going to be able to eat this in one bite. Yes. Burger is your standard meaty burger. Love it. But the Stilton's very strong, which is if you're going to order a Stilton burger, you want strong Stilton. And the mushroom's lovely as well, so can't go wrong, can you? £12.50, great surroundings, great food, spot on. I think if you come here with your family for a treat as a one-off, maybe once a year. The bill's going to come to, say, £20 an adult, £15 a child. About 70 quid, isn't it? One-off a year, I think you can do that as a family. I mean, you're going to pay about £50 anyway, so for an extra 20 quid, you're getting these shows and the performances. So yeah, great. Right, if you leave me to it, I'm going to enjoy the rest of my burger. And yeah, I'll see you afterwards. Bye. Right, so there you have it. Evolution Experience Restaurant. It was great, loved it. Great theming, lovely food. I mean, it was genuinely nice food. The burger was meaty, the Stilton was strong, which I know that's not for everybody, but for the people that like Stilton, great. And the mushroom was lovely. And the portion size was okay for £12.50. I mean, you wouldn't expect any bigger portions of that. It was a decent sized burger. There was shows intermittently. I'd say every, 10-15 minutes there was like a lightning storm and then a dinosaur popped out and stuff. So it was great, really enjoyed that. And that's the closest kind of themed restaurant to Teesside that I'm aware of. Otherwise, really, you have to go to kind of London for the Rainforest Cafe. Or you could go to Florida, which is a little bit further. But yeah, really enjoyed that. So definitely recommend it. I'm just thinking there's also the roller coaster restaurant cafe in Alton Towers, but it's not quite the same because it's not really a dark kind of restaurant. That's very bright and your food comes down on tracks, so the theming isn't over the top at that one. But still, this one is a lot closer to Teesside. This is about an hour and a half from Teesside as opposed to kind of 2.5 hours over at Alton Towers. So yeah, gonna head back now to the car park. We have got our coach trips here throughout the year. We've got the next one coming up in April. Strongly recommend that. If you are from Teesside, please then just check out myfamilyoutings.co.uk or Family Outings Northeast on our Facebook channel. The zoo itself, it was great. I mean, it's a massive zoo. Take you all day to get round. I mean, I whipped round quite quick. I don't have any kids with me, so it's definitely a full day attraction if you do come with your children. The animals are clearly well looked after. There's plenty of animals to look at. And actually, you can get quite close to them, very close. I mean, I would probably say this is up there with Chester Zoo for me. As an overall package, some things are better than Chester Zoo here, some things Chester Zoo a little bit better than here, but overall combined, I would say this and Chester Zoo are my joint favourites. I don't want to say one's better than the other because I do love Chester Zoo, but I would say this is definitely up there. It's got some additional things as well, as I say, like I love this outdoor kind of area before you get into the zoo. And the extra things that you can do here. So, you know, if you come with your kids and for whatever reason, I doubt you would, but you wouldn't want to spend the full day in the zoo, you can also go to that indoor play area, or you can go to this restaurant and just finish off your day in style. So perfect, have absolutely loved it. Once again, thank you very much to Yorkshire Wildlife Park for inviting me here for free. Got in there today, and I look forward to coming back throughout the year. So thanks very much for watching, everybody. Please like the video, subscribe to the channel, and I will see you all again very soon. Bye.